Mel Gibson can't suppress his inner Nazi. It just keeps coming out. Why is that? Because the guy is a Nazi. His ex-girlfriend taped him, and somehow the tapes mysteriously leaked out. Thank goodness. He tells her that she's a slut. If she goes out dressed the way she is, she's going to get gang raped, and he drops the N-bomb. He says that word. And basically, he's taking his rage and his violence that he wants to direct on to her and projects it on innocent black men. Then he says, I'm going to come back to the house and burn down the house, but before I do, I'm going to make you give me oral sex. And that wasn't the words I'm sure he used. The guy is vile. He is a racist, an anti-Semite, and a misogynist. He hates women. Now, where better to be than Hollywood with tons of money to exploit, intimidate, and make women fear for their safety than Hollywood and get away with it? This guy was caught drunk driving. You can murder people when you're drunk behind a wheel. He was caught drunk driving. He got away with that. He made an anti-Semitic comment and got away with that. He seems to be getting away with anything. This chick, she's a gold digger. She doesn't have any talent, but she's done one damn good thing in her life. She taped this bum without him knowing, and now has finally exposed what we all know. Mel Gibson is such a low life. He is, his father's a Holocaust denier. And oh yeah, let's get back to the church. The church pushes this movie. The church has a history of anti-Semitism and blaming the Jews. The church has a history of covering for their own pedophiles. And the church doesn't seem to have a problem with Mel being an adulterer, a liar, a racist, and an anti-Semite. Anyway, I checked into my Yiddish, and Mel Gibson translated into Yiddish means anti-Semite, low-life thug, racist, misogynist.